In the fall, everything changes. Fall is electric, intense. Summer slips into cool autumn nights. And for the first time, we feel the focus and the pressure of time. In the fall, heroes are born, legends rise, and history is made. Fall is a time for greatness. Fall is winning time. Let's do this.
Hello, baseball fans. I'm Matt Vaskirjian. Welcome to the show. MLB Network is your exclusive home for postseason baseball. It's Game 6 of this year's Fall Classic between the Washington Nationals and the Houston Astros. Hi again, everybody. Matt Vaskirjian. Welcome to the World Series here on MLB Network. With me is Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac. And Dan, obviously, a lot of things still up in the air as we get ready for Game 6.
For my money, there's nothing better than postseason baseball. Every game is critical, and one swing, one error, or even one pitch can make all the difference. Let's get this thing going already. Roll the ball out there and let's play.
The build-up to this one is just about over. It's time for all the drama of World Series baseball on MLB Network, and we'll have it all for you next. Getting close to first pitch here. Let's listen in to public address announcer Alex Miniak. And briefly here, a glance at the two starters who'll get the ball here in this one. And here's how the Nats line up in this one. Who do you have your eye on, Dan?
Yeah, Matt, I'm really excited to see what Ryan Zimmerman has in store. He's got over 1,000 RBIs. He's already proved he's a clutch hitter. He knows how to drive in big runs when it counts. So if the situation comes up in this game, I'm looking to watch how he goes to work in the clutch.
Justin Verlander, a Virginia-born right-hander, gets the ball to start this one. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Yeah, Matt, since he's put on a Houston Astros uniform, Justin Verlander's kind of turned his career around. Went through a couple of seasons where his velocity was down, but he's always had that good curveball changeup combination. Velo back up to the mid to upper 90s to go along with that fastball and the curveball, and Justin Verlander is all the way back.
Time for a look at the Houston Astros on D. And let's take a look at Carlos Correa. I had an old friend say to me one time, this is what they look like. And this is exactly what it looks like. The ability to play gold glove defense and hit in the middle of the order. I smell a potential Hall of Fame career.
Here's Howie Kendrick. And we are set for baseball here this evening. The 1-1. Is in there for strike number two. And a good pitch there as this is swung on and missed for the first out of the ball game. Another strikeout for him on the mound, and boy, is it fun to watch him go about his business.
No doubt, Matty. He's one of my favorites, mostly because of his stuff. You know, he can absolutely dominate on any given day because of what he offers up there. It's just nasty. There aren't many hitters that like to see this guy on the mound.
Another full count pitch home. He is swung on and missed. He got him.
One thing to know is not all strikeouts are created equal. Right there, he goes down on strikes, but he really made that guy on the mound work for it. And when you're doing that in the first inning, it can have an effect on how deep he's going to be able to go into this start. There's a big difference between that and going down on three or four pitches.
In is Gerardo Parra. First two men in the inning have both gone down via the punch out, so we'll see if he can fare any better. And just a masterful job of pitching here as he strikes out the side in order. Nationals gone in order, and now the Astros will go to work for the first time. No score. Time now for a quick look at the hometown Astros starting lineup. Mark, what's your take on him against one of the best starters in the game?
Matty, you take a look at this lineup, I find myself thinking back to my playing days when I knew I had the ace on the mound. It had to be win day, and when you get in a car to drive to the yard, you tell yourself, even though you felt bad about it, just get two or three. All the pressure's on the big boy to have to execute, and he usually does. Look for this lineup to try and execute and score, manufacture one or two runs early in this one. Time for a look at the Curly W on D. And let's focus our attention on second baseman Brian Dozier. We know what he can do from the offensive standpoint, light tower power, but he doesn't get enough credit for his defense, his ability to manipulate the bag and do all this while his hair never moves.
Now at the plate, Martin Maldonado. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. Grounded down the third baseline. Scooped up on the backhand. On to first with it is Kendrick, and it's in plenty of time for the first out. Digging in, Michael Brantley, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Hit softly on the ground to first, and he'll take it onto the bag himself. Two gone now here in the first. In now, Yuli Gurriel. No one aboard for him, and two gone here in the first. Two out, nobody on. Throws him for strike three, and that retires the side. 1-2-3 go the Astros. We are still scoreless. Here's Ryan Zimmerman now. He'll get us started in the top of the second. Woo! Now the 1-1 pitch. Grounded to third. Throw to first will be in time, and there's one gone here to start the second. Coming to the plate now, Michael Taylor. And the fastball easy to lay off that time, 2-2. And there are our umpires for this one. Working the plate is Dave Lawrence.
Yeah, Dan, we got Dave Lawrence behind the dish tonight. One of the best in the game, I think. Consistent, well-respected, accurate strike zone.
Debro, you hit it right there. He makes you bring the ball up.
Belted high in the air out to left. Brantley going back. It's up and out of here into the archways. A solo home run there for Michael Taylor. His second home run of the series. As the Nationals strike first, it's 1-0.
Everybody loves to get on a good piece of cheese, hit a fastball out of the yard. But I tell you what, to be able to stay back and take a curveball deep, it's one of those special feelings when you can recognize and react, keep your hands back, and drive it out of the yard.
In now, Brian Dozier. And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. One out, nobody on. 2 high that time, and it's 3-1. Adam Eaton is on deck. He'll hit next. The 3-1. Finds the zone to fill the count, 3-2. Oh, and this is swung on and missed. 4 strikeouts already, and that's out number 2.
That swing tells me he was really trying to get a pitch out front and rip it down the line, but that wasn't a great pitch to do it on. It's really not the best 2-strike approach either.
Standing in now, Adam Eaton. That nibbled the corner there, but missed, 2-1. Line to the right side. Reddick will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. Nats on the board first, courtesy of the solo home run. We'll go to the bottom of the second. It's now 1-0 Washington. popped him up. And he'll indeed make the play in foul territory for the first down. Riding in, Jose Altuve. A ball and two strikes. The 1-2 is laid off for ball two.
Boy, if you're going to throw a pitch like that to this guy, you have to make sure it's up above the zone like that. He can't do a whole lot with that, but if it were a little lower, he can and will make you pay big time.
Here now the 2-2. Swung on and missed, strike three.
Boy, there's nothing like seeing a good power pitcher that has a good fastball. And what does he do? He just throws this good fastball right by, brings the express. No chance to put that ball in play.
Into the box, Jake Mariznick. And he pumps the fastball by him here. 1-2 now. Count still at 1-2. The 1-2 is swung on and missed, strike three. Astros go down 1-2-3. They still trail 1-0. Back with Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac, and starting out the inning, the exciting speedster Trey Turner. And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. The 2-1 home. Takes a pitch for strike number two.
Oh, that's for sure going to be a pitch he wants back. You're not going to get many balls right in the wheelhouse from a top-level arm like this.
And this is swung on and missed. 5 quick strikeouts now, and that's your first out of the inning.
It's always nice to keep a guy that has good wheels off base, and that's just what they did right there. Big strikeout, keep that guy off the base path.
Bases are empty, one man out. No offer on that one, and Verlander's run at full now, 3-2. Waiting on deck is Howie Kendrick. Now the payoff pitch home. And he takes ball four. So a good job out of the nine hole in getting on base as we go back to the top of the order.
Well, he battled to get it to a 3-2 count, but that pitch wasn't even close. Now he's got a man on with one out, so he's got to focus on trying to get the ground ball.
Back to the top of the order now, and digging in the third baseman, Howie Kendrick. The 1-1 hit well on the ground to first, and he tries to go to a knee to block it, but it's by him down the right field line, and that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
You know, as a former infielder, Danny, they always say you can't be in two places at once, but you got to be a little frustrated right here that ball found the hole.
Yeah, that's a tough thing. You make a quality pitch and a guy shoots one through the right side, normally a vacated spot right there. 9 out of 10 times somebody's there to make that play. Unfortunately not, and now we've got a couple of guys on.
And the off-balance throw beats him at first, and that's a tough play. Two men on, two out, and that'll bring up a multiple gold glover, the left-handed hitting Gerardo Parra. Three and one, the pitch. Now a slider here, but this will miss off the plate away, and it's ball four.
And that's two free passes in the third inning alone, so you have to wonder if maybe it's something mechanical or if it's just psychological. Got to get back on track here.
So striding in, Ryan Zimmerman. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. Ready with the 1-2. Fouled away. The set and the 1-2. And he comes back to get him. So a great job pitching out of it with the bases loaded. A couple of walks, but no damage. More baseball on MLB Network right after this. And that'll bring up the former first rounder, Alex Bregman. 7, 8, and 9 to start the home third.
Not much going on offensively so far for these guys. 6 up, 6 down. We'll see if the bottom part of the lineup can get something going.
Well, the home crowd seems a little restless, so I'm sure they'd appreciate it. Now the 3-2 pitch. It's a high fly ball headed for the left field corner. If it stays fair, it's gone. But it bends just foul into the second deck. He'll try it again, 3-2. And he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. And there's out number one. One out now in the Houston third. And the former number one overall pick in American League Rookie of the Year, Carlos Correa, bats next. Astros still have yet to tally their first hit in this one. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2. Robinson Chirinos waits on deck. And this is hit hard to the right side. Foul. Payoff pitch one more time. Sent in the air out to straightaway central. Taylor is back and he'll get there to make the play for route number two. So bases are empty here with two gone, and that'll bring up the catcher, Robinson Chirinos. Strasburg on 1-1, and it's fouled away. Strasburg comes set. Here's the 1-2. Swing and a miss at a big breaking ball, and that's how the inning comes to an end. 1-2-3 go the Astros. They trail this one 1-0. And we're back in Houston. Welcome back to Minute Maid Park as we check in with Heidi.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Nationals manager Dave Martinez between innings, specifically about his club's offense to this point.
And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats.
Yes, they've only scored one run, but he said they've done a great job of forcing the pitch count up, and he thinks that's going to lead to more offense for them as this game goes on.
All right. Thanks, Heidi. Now with the plate, Michael Taylor, and he's off to a hot start in this one. Homered his first time around.
And that's been the entire offense so far in this one. They've been shut down other than that.
The 2-1 home. Hit fairly well out towards straightaway center. Mariznick is under it. Makes the play, one away. So with the fly out there coming on the fastball, seems like an appropriate time to check out our pitch speed comparison for these two starters. And we've got two guys bringing some serious gas for you, as you see there. Top speeds 96 and 97. So one away here with the bases empty, and that'll bring up the power hitting second baseman Brian Dozier. The 1-1. Misses off the plate. This one's outside, quite a bit off the plate that time. One out, nobody on. Too high, and that cost him ball four. Standing in, Adam Eaton hit it hard but lined out in his first at bat.
Yeah, pretty unlucky right there, Matty. Squared up the fastball nicely, and that's all you can do. You just want to be on time for the heater, and he's prepared for this next AB.
And a wave and a miss on a ball that was way out of the strike zone. There are two away now.
Really impressive pitching right there. Sometimes as a pitcher, you can get frustrated when you make a good pitch and you don't get that call from the umpire. But what does he do? He comes back with a good pitch and gets the strike.
Into the box now, Trey Turner. And he fouls this one off. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Fouled off. No offer on that one, and Verlander's run at full now, 3-2.
Full count with two outs now, so if he could put the ball in the gap somewhere, he could have a good shot of driving in a run because the runner at first will be in motion.
And a good at-bat that time as he lays off for ball four, and as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away.
He did not want to let the hitter off the hook with two outs, and now he's got a runner in scoring position to deal with.
Stepping up now, Asdrubal Cabrera. He drew a base on balls his first time up. Inside here with the hard stuff, and it's 2-1 now.
Well, I know the last thing he wants to do is load the bases right here, so the pressure is on right now to get back in the strike zone.
The 2-1 pitch.
Nope.
Just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call.
There isn't a hitter alive that doesn't love hitting at fastball counts like 3-1. It's usually a pretty fruitful count in terms of getting a pitch to drive.
Fouled away. Struck him out, his eighth punch out of the ballgame, and that one ends the inning. Nats leave a pair, but they lead it 1-0. Into the box now, Martin Maldonado back to the top of the lineup as they're still looking for their first base runner in this one.
No doubt about that, Matt. They've yet to figure this guy out on the mound. He's looked great so far.
He has, but we'll see if this second trip through the order changes anything.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see what kind of adjustments these hitters are able to make in the middle innings of this game.
Let's go, Houston. The 1-1. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Hunt has a read on it. One down. So digging in now, Michael Brantley. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. No runs, no hits, no errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. Over at the knees, and that's the second strike. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now.
With the meat of the order due up next, you can probably expect to see something you can handle here with the full count as the two-hole hitter.
A bouncer up the middle. Turner has it. On to first, and Strasburg's in control here, two away. Cuban import Yuli Gurriel. And Dan, it seems like this starter is just dominating the game right now. Feels like we're seeing a lot of three up, three down innings.
No doubt about that, Matt. Hey, I've enjoyed watching him go about his business, but I'm also interested to see if this offense can figure out a way to get a couple of cracks in his armor before it gets too late.
Yeah, that remains to be seen. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. No runs, no hits, no errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. There's the big breaking ball, and it's by him for a strike. Two one more time, and it's fouled away. Another try at 2-2. Trying to nibble here, and he misses to run it full now. 3-2.
I got to commend him for being a really tough out right now. Not everyone will battle like this with two outs and nobody on.
Him up. Zimmerman is there, and that retires the side. Astros go down 1-2-3. They're down 1-0. Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, Howie Kendrick. He's 1-for-2 in this one. count now at 2-2. And that misses, so it's a full count, 3-2. Hit down the third baseline, but this will get foul, so they'll do it again, 3-2. Once again, a 3-2. Grounder down the line at third. And that's a fair ball as this one gets by him at third.
Hey, they weren't going to keep this guy down for long. That's the ebbs and flows of a baseball season. Bottom line is this guy has bat-to-ball skills. You knew he was going to get hot eventually.
Digging in once again, Kurt Suzuki. He was a ground-out victim last time up.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result. That's his last at-bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
The 2-1. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Under it is Mariznick, one away. Riding in once again, Gerardo Parra. It was a walk in his last trip. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Oh, he's really got the strikeout pitch working now as he notches number 9 in the ball game.
Pretty textbook breaking ball for the punch out right there. Got it to bend a lot, and by the time it got there, it had fallen completely out of the zone. Not much you can do with that pitch.
In now, Ryan Zimmerman. Lazy fly ball out to center field. Here comes Mariznick. He's there to track it down, and that'll end the inning. One left for Washington. They lead it 1-0. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Astros manager A.J. Hinch between innings, specifically about his club's offense to this point.
And he was pretty blunt in saying they're just not having very good at-bats. They haven't had a single guy on base yet, so it's starting to feel a little desperate down here. But he said they've unfortunately just been faced with some really great pitching today. The key going forward is to find any way they can to get him out of his rhythm on the mound. Now, that may be a tall task, but they feel the little adjustments could lead to things turning around for them.
Thank you, Heidi. Reddick waiting, and now the pitch. Well above the letters with the fastball that time. And he fouls this one off. Now a changeup locks him up as he looks at strike 3 called, one away.
This guy is really locked in on the bump right now. He's just playing good old-fashioned hardball right now, just rearing back and letting it go. And it seems like this lineup, they don't have an answer for anything he's bringing so far.
Here's the second baseman, Jose Altuve. Bases are empty, one man out. Grounded weakly down the line toward third. Foul. That's softly hit to right. Will that get down? Dozier takes charge out there, and he stays with it for the second out. A look at our line score to this point, and I'm almost certainly jinxing things by pointing it out, but it's worth mentioning that zero in the hit column through two outs here in the fifth. Next up for the Stros, Jake Mariznick. His guy's still looking at a zero in the hit column. Bases are empty here with two men out. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball.
Let's go, Astros!
Three and one now.
He's had command of his pitches all day, hasn't walked a soul, but we find ourselves in a three ball count here. Want to see how aggressive he gets in the zone.
Three and one, here it is. Skied into straightaway right. Eaton is right there, and that will retire the side. 1-2-3 go the Astros. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. Into the box, Michael Taylor. He comes in 1-for-2 with that home run he hit earlier. Now the 1-1 pitch. Strike two swinging. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. The 1-2. Misses, ball two. And he struck him out. So double digits now. 10 strikeouts for him thus far.
That's 10 strikeouts for him now. And I'll tell you, he could rack up quite a few more before he's done. Still a lot of game left in this one.
Here's Brian Dozier now. It was a walk in his last trip. And he struck him out. And there's strikeout number 11 in the ballgame.
Wow, that's one of the toughest pitches in baseball to hit, right? That good straight changeup, El Cambio. There's not much you can do with that. You're going off of that arm speed and the ball, it just doesn't get there.
Standing in now, Adam Eaton. Checks his swing here, but he does so in time. And with just 5 2/3 innings under his belt, he's about to hit the century mark in his pitch count now.
Yeah, Matty V, and the way baseball is played these days, it's about 6 innings or 100 heaves, and you're pretty much looking for that bullpen. And D-Roll right now, this guy's pretty vulnerable right now at this game.
Yeah, Dan, you are a monster down that bullpen. That's what it seems to be in today's game. There's 5 or 6 of you guys hanging out down there. So he's going to empty the bucket right here until the manager gets him.
Fouled off. The 2-2 one more time. Doesn't get the zone. Count full now. Trey Turner would be next. Now the payoff pitch home. Fouled away.
Can't imagine he comes back with a third breaking ball. That hitter looked like he timed that one up pretty well and just missed it, fouling it away.
The next 3-2. And a fastball misses there, ball four.
I know one thing, he earned that free pass right there. He was tempted with some really good pitches, but he stayed disciplined and drew the walk.
Ready once again, Trey Turner. And we'll see if they can make him pay for the two-out walk. Always considered a big no-no, of course. 2-1 the count to Trey Turner. Swung on and missed, and it's even at 2-2. He stays alive, still 2-2. The 2-2 one more time is looked at off the plate for a ball.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
3-2 pitch. Now a swing and a fly ball. Reddick coming on, but this will land untouched. And another foul ball. Eaton is off of first with two away. And he misses again, ball four, and his control is really letting him down now. Now here comes the Houston manager out of the dugout on his way to the mound. And he's going to motion for the bullpen. That'll end the evening for Justin Verlander. He'll depart after 5 2/3, as it'll be up to the bullpen to keep his guys in the ballgame. Josh James trots in from the bullpen here as he inherits a tough spot with two on and two away. As Drubal Cabrera will be his first assignment here, as he'll face him with runners at first and second and two away. Woo-hoo! Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch lifted the other way out to left center. And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. Nats leave a pair, but they hold a 1-0 lead. So striding forward now, Alex Bregman, 0-for-1 for him here in this one.
We're moving through the middle of this ball game right now. If they want to get things going, how about trying to get some base runners on, or at least get a base hit? They don't have any hits going into this part of the game.
On that fastball's too much for him there, 1-2.
Just reached back and threw a high fastball right by him. He didn't stand a chance.
The 1-2 is a fastball in off the plate for a ball. The pitch just hung in there on that one. Here's another 2-2. Hot shot to third and handled for the first down. Here's Carlos Correa now. He's 0-for-1 thus far. One out, nobody on. Well outside with the curveball for a ball. Correa in front, three balls and a strike.
Well, it's a pretty well-known fact that your batting average goes up as you get into more favorable hitters counts, and that's especially true when we're talking about this kind of hitter. Not a great spot to be in if you're the pitcher.
Hard on the ground toward short. Turner gloves it. Throw in time as he's called out on a bang-bang play at first.
When the guy on the mound is working on a no-no this late, every play is exciting and stressful for the fielders. We'll see if they can continue making the plays behind him.
Now the Astros' designated hitter, Robinson Chirinos, comes into this at-bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And nearly into the hit column in a big way. Instead, it's a foul ball. Ball two.
Pretty standard curve in the dirt, looking for a strikeout there, but that was a good job of recognizing it and holding back at the plate.
Two out, nobody on. Looks at a fastball low here, and it's full 3-2. Looking to fade his first walk. Here it comes. And he struck him out. So it might be time to begin the countdown as he's now gone through six innings without allowing a base hit. Astros go down 1-2-3. It remains 1-0. Back here at Minute Maid Park in Houston. Game 6 moves on to the 7th inning now, but before we start, let's call on our game summary to show you how we got here. So the lineup flips over, and digging in, Howie Kendrick. He's 2-for-3 thus far. Kendrick waiting. Now the pitch. Can't do much with that one. It's 1-2.
Great spot with that pitch down and away. He'll be fine coming out of the bullpen in this one if he can keep hitting that spot.
The 1-2 is a wave and a miss. He struck him out.
Nice job there taking care of the leadoff hitter via the strikeout. I'll tell you, in a one-run game, especially this late, getting that first guy in the inning is so important. It changes the whole complexion of the inning, so that was a big out.
Into the box now, Kurt Suzuki. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Time to focus here. This game is way too close to be walking, guys, so we'll see if he can make him swing the bat on this next pitch.
A bouncer to the left side. Correa fields it cleanly. On to first, and Suzuki is retired, 2 away. At the plate, Gerardo Parra. He comes in 0-for-2 thus far. Bases are empty here with two men out. On a line, that's a base hit.
Boy, Dero, the game of baseball has changed. There's so much velocity in the game. That was a 96-mile-an-hour fastball that he smoked the other way.
Yeah, you have to keep your front shoulder tough right there. You have to honor. When a guy's throwing that hard, 96 miles an hour, you have to honor that fastball and try and work it the other way to keep you on the off speed.
Stepping in now, Ryan Zimmerman. 2 balls and 2 strikes, the count to Ryan Zimmerman. Runner at first with two gone. And that misses there, so he runs the count full now. Michael Taylor would be next. Working for the punch out and the offering. Full count still. Now the 3-2 pitch, and it's fouled away. Payoff pitch one more time. Another one sent foul. And that misses ball four. So it's first and second now with two out.
Well, he made quick work of the first two guys this half inning, getting two quick outs, but then he gives up a base hit and now the walk. We'll see if he has it in him to draw the line in the sand and get out of this.
Michael Taylor will stand in again as we take you back to earlier in the ball game. This one swing here has been the entire offense to this point, as this home run accounted for the only run they've tallied so far. And that fastball's too much for him there. 1-2.
Boy, the Nationals could use a big hit right here. They really haven't been able to do much all game long. This would be a great time to get something going.
The 1-2 pitch. He got him. Lively fastball that time, and it puts an end to the inning. Nats leave a pair, but they're up 1-0. So the Houston lineup turns over, and to the plate, Martin Maldonado. It was a flyout for him in his last trip.
Starting to run out of time. They haven't been able to score any runs as we're moving late into this one. A perfect time for this leadoff guy to try to get on base and ignite a rally.
And that's a base hit. So the perfect game bid ends in the seventh. They finally break through for their first hit of the ball game, so the no-hit bid will end right here.
Yeah, Matty D, this is when you start thinking about that no-no. You get into the seventh inning, D-O. As a pitcher, you start looking ahead to what might happen.
And that donut stares at you from an offensive standpoint as well. This guy's had his A game. You can't deny the fact that he's pitched a heck of a game, but from an offensive standpoint, you never stop grinding to get a crooked number up on that board.
As a hitter, you know the pitcher's trying to work you down around the knees in a double play situation. So making him get a pitch up and actually in the zone is a must.
And that's going to be high, 2-2 now. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. He's set. Here's the 2-2. And he struck him out.
Really important time for a strikeout there, guys. Tying run at first, so objective number one is stranding him on base. And now with one out, it becomes a lot more difficult to manufacture that run.
Striding into the box, Yuli Gurriel. In his last at-bat, he popped out in foul ground.
Yeah, Matt, he's got to make an adjustment right here. His swing definitely broke down, dropped his back shoulder, and thus the result was a terrible pop-up foul.
And he struck him out, and that's 8 strikeouts thus far.
That's a big strikeout there with the tying run over at first base. Now, with 2 outs, it becomes a lot more difficult to manufacture that guy home. Probably need a ball in the gap to give him a chance.
So it's a runner at first with 2 men out, and that brings up the former Gold Glover Josh Reddick. Maldonado leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. Drill down the line, but this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2.
pulled toward right center field. Eaton is under it. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. One left for Houston. They still trail 1-0. Chris Devinsky has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth. Stepping into the box, Brian Dozier. No hits to this point. Two balls and a strike to Dozier.
You got two balls, one strike.
And a fastball, but he's losing it a bit here to 3-1 now. And he fouls this one off. And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one. Pitching certainly has been on display in this one, and there's the evidence of it right there. 1-0 our score, as there are an awful lot of zeros on that line score to this point. In now is Adam Eaton, 0-for-2 on his line thus far. One and two now to Adam Eaton.
Hey, I get it. You're all in fastball. You're pulling the trigger at almost anything. But that is way too high. He's going to have to lower his sights.
The 1-2. Lifted in the air toward the line and right. But this is going to wind up a foul ball. Line towards center field. Oh, and he misses it. The throw into second, and he is in there.
Man, I'm not sure what to make of this one. The ball was hit hard, but it looked routine. The only thing I could think of is maybe he lost it in the lights there. That's a tough break.
Into the box now, Trey Turner. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1. Set and the 2-1 pitch. Ani gets him to wave at that one. It's 2-2. Sure took a healthy hack that time.
Yeah, and I don't understand that approach at all, Matty. He's not really known for having a whole lot of pop in his bat, but he is known for having really good speed. So, personally, I'd much rather see him with a controlled swing and try to put the ball in play.
2-2 pitch is fouled away. One out and a runner on second base. Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on, and when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
Into the box as Drubel Cabrera. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. The 1-2 pitch. Here's a fastball in on the fist, and that'll even things up at 2-2. Two out here and a runner at second. Oh, they pulled the string on a good changeup there as he swings and misses, and he's set down on strikes for the second time tonight. Nationals leave one, but they're on top 1-0. Now batting, Jose Altuve. He'll start things out against Steven Strasburg as we get the inning underway.
This thing's far from over, even though we're moving into the back end of this game. Only down by one. All they need to do is get this leadoff guy, and they're an extra base hit away from tying this thing up.
Now Altuve connects. Deep left field. That one is out of here. This game is tied. Solo shot here to left, and this ball game is tied at one.
I mean, you have to love the World Series. What a game we have right now. Home run ties it late. Place is going absolutely bananas. Would you rather be anywhere else?
Now the Nationals skipper is up out of the dugout on his way to the mound. And that's going to do it now for Steven Strasburg. So he departs in a tie ball game here tonight. You can already hang a no decision on him for this one. Daniel Hudson is on the pitch here in the eighth with nobody out. Standing in now, Jake Mariznick, fouled off. Here's another 1-2. And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. No outs, nobody on. Fouled away. The 2-2 one more time. He spoils another one and will do it again. And it's fouled away. The 2-2. And look out as that one ran in and got him.
Well, he might be feeling a little bit of a sting there, but he could take comfort in knowing that he represents the go-ahead run. That could turn out to be a huge hit by pitch.
Delivery, a check on that go-ahead run at first. Go-ahead runs aboard here at first with nobody out. Stepping in now, Alex Bregman. And he misses with it, ball four. So the potential go-ahead run moves into scoring position now.
You know, it takes a lot of discipline to watch a pitch like that go by. But on a 3-1 count, he had the luxury of being a little bit more selective up there. Good take, and a walk is the result.
Digging in to try it again, Carlos Correa. He's 0-2 thus far in this one. the 2-1 home. Popped him up. Zimmerman in foul ground. One out. So it's a tight spot here. First and second, one man out, and that'll bring up the catcher, Robinson Chirinos. Marisnik on second, Bregman at first, one gone. Ready now. Two-strike pitch on its way. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. The 2-2 is a fastball that misses.
Well, no doubt in my mind, this has been the at-bat of the night so far.
Payoff pitch home, and that misses for ball four. So the potential go-ahead run moves over to third now.
I think he was trying to be a little too fine there, and a walk is the result. Well, the good news is he has a force at every base. The bad news, a single probably drives in a couple of runs.
Digging in and looking for more, Martin Maldonado. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. Bases are loaded with only one out. The 1-2 locks him up for strike three.
I like how he worked him backwards for that strikeout there. He wasn't showing the fastball early in the at-bat, but then went back-to-back once he had the hitter down in the count.
Here's Michael Brantley. Not much in the way of productivity from him so far, but he's got a chance to come through here in a crucial spot.
Yeah, it's time now that he has to put the rest of those bats behind him, because none of that matters if he can clutch up when it really counts.
Two pitch, and he fouls this one off.
Hey, great job just to be able to foul that one off. In today's game, that's what we're seeing north-south. Pitchers want to elevate, want to get you out above the zone or below it.
Fouled off. Here's the 1-2. Fouled away. Ready with the 1-2. This is on the ground to short. Is he going to get out of this? He is. They get the force at second base, and the inning is over. Astros able to tie it here on the solo home run. On to the ninth inning here at Minute Maid Park. All even at one apiece. And now for Washington, Howie Kendrick. He went down on strikes last time up.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Under it now is Brantley, and he has it for the first out. Striding in now for the Nats, Kurt Suzuki. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. And he misses badly with a fastball here, and it's 3-1 now.
MVP! MVP!
And he lays off ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here. Now time is called, and we'll have a pinch runner at first, and that'll be a wise decision as he's the potential go-ahead run. Settling in now, Gerardo Parra. There's one away. The runner at first represents the potential go-ahead score. Double play is in order, however. Now the 1-2 pitch. Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game.
It's been a rough game for him at the plate. Couldn't get the bat off his shoulder right there, and he struck out twice before that one. So he's going to have a lot to think about when he leaves the ballpark tonight.
In now, Ryan Zimmerman. Runners on the move for second. Grounded back up the middle. Oh, and he can't pick it up cleanly. And a great job to stick with it as he's able to make the play for the third out. So no runs on no hits, no errors, and a runner left on. The Astros looking to send their fans home happy. Bottom of the ninth coming up. Tanner Rainey enters to do the pitching, and best case scenario for him is to push this one into extra innings. Yan Gomes is into the ballgame here as he takes over behind the plate. Stepping into the box, Yuli Gurriel. He was sent packing on strikes in his last trip.
Yeah, Matty, and hopefully he got it out of his system, especially now he's got a bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot, has to put the ball in play.
Fly ball out to straightaway center. Taylor is there. Makes the play, one away. And there are the final numbers for the Washington starter. And he really delivered a fantastic postseason performance.
Hey, what a great job of mixing speeds and mixing up his pitches. Two hits allowed in this one. Dominant performance.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Josh Reddick. He could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far. Reddick behind a ball and two strikes. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Bases are empty, one man out. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Parra is in his tracks now as he makes the catch for out number two. trying to pick things up where he left off. Jose Altuve, he's working on a 1-for-3 thus far.
The last at-bat, Matty D, we heard this guy's a good fastball hitter. He got a fastball and didn't miss it. We'll see if they pitch him a little bit differently this time and mix in some off-speed pitches.
And he lays off ball four, so now the potential winning run is aboard at first. At the plate, Jake Marisnyk. He's got a chance to end this one and send these fans home happy if he can get a ball deep enough into the gap. Counts even at 2-2 to Marisnyk.
Don't know for sure, but I think he may have been taking there thinking his teammate on first was going to be on the move.
The 2-2, and it's fouled away.
Classic change of speeds right there. Threw the hitter's timing off. Got a late foul ball. Interested to see where he goes now.
Hard hit toward the hole. Oh, and he can't pick it up cleanly. And the throw won't be in time as he'll be able to beat out the recovery throw at first.
Nice effort by the shortstop right there. Kept it in front of him. That's all he could do right there, Dan.
You know, Dealer, in a spot like that, that's an infield single. That's a tough play. Just to knock that ball down was a pretty good job. But any way you look at it, that should be scored a base hit, and I'm sure it was.
Stepping in, Alex Bregman. He's gone hitless to this point.
Not a great game up to this point, but none of that would matter if he could come through right here. A chance to be the hero.
The 1-1 pitch. And this one's in the dirt. Good job to corral this quickly as the runners hold on. Called strike two.
Pretty adamant about working him inside right now. Back-to-back fastballs, and that one was able to find the zone.
And he tries to get him to reach for it, but it stays outside. 3-2. Here's the payoff pitch. Ball four, and that will move the winning run over to third base now, just 90 feet away. At the plate, Carlos Correa. A two-out hit and win it. Pass ball or wild pitch would do the trick just as well. The 1-1 pitch. Slow roller down the third baseline, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. From the stretch, the 1-2. And here's one that barely misses off the inside corner. 2-2.
This is the action pitch right here. He does not want to go to full count. This is a big spot. But as an offensive player, you have to tell yourself this has to be in the strike zone.
The 2-2. And he strikes him out. So a missed opportunity at the plate as he strands three runners and the side is retired. So they can't get that winning run home, and that means we'll have to go a little longer tonight to find a winner. 10th inning coming up, all tied at 1-1. Ryan Pressly takes the mound as he'll be the first man to pitch here in extra innings. Stepping in, Michael Taylor. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
The 2-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. So stepping in, Brian Dozier. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. One out, nobody on. One and two as he chases the slider.
Is that gun reading right there? Because that just registered at 91 miles an hour on a slider. If he's working that pitch, that's most guys' fastballs. It's going to be a long game.
And he'll strike out here yet again, as it's been a ball game to forget thus far. Four strikeouts.
Wow, he's just a lost cause in this one. That's the fourth time he struck out in this game alone, and that's not something you'll forget very quickly. That's about as bad of a day as you could have.
Into the box, Adam Eaton popped up. Gurriel is there for it. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. Three up, three down for Washington. Still tied, one apiece. Fernando Rodney comes on to start the home 10th, and he's just hoping to get this one into the 11th inning. Striding forward now is the DH, Robinson Chirinos. He's 0 for 2 in the ballgame so far. And he lays off this one down and in for ball two. The 2-1 home takes this the other way to right. Eaton is there, one away. So the batting order turns over now and set to go Martin Maldonado. It was a backwards K, a strikeout looking for him in his last at bat.
Yeah, Matty, and he was locked up by a good fastball for strike three last time. I'm interested to see if they attack him the same way, come at him with hard velo late, or snap something off in the dirt to see if he'll fish.
The 2-1 home, taken on the outside corner for strike two. Swing and a miss as he ran that two-seamer right by him for the second out.
Well, we'll see a lot of these power arms coming out of the bullpen in these days, but it doesn't make it any less impressive to me. I love watching guys come in and blow smoke right by guys.
Into the box now, Michael Brantley. Hit out towards second. Throw on to first, and we are going to the 11th inning. 1-2-3 go the Astros. Score remains tied 1-1. Digging in, Trey Turner. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Yeah, he's got to put that one behind him, especially with runners in scoring position. Those punch-outs will stick with you a little longer.
Get him. ready on 1-2. Tried to shoot the corner and he missed it. 2-2.
Here we go, Astros.
Now the pitch.
Got him.
And he goes down on strikes for the third time.
Wow, we've seen some really impressive pitching in this one. You could say these lineups have been anemic, but I always like to give credit to pitching and defense, and they've been fantastic all game long.
Anthony Rendon will move into the on-deck circle now to try to get something started here with one gone in the inning. Fastball well outside. Bases are empty, one man out. All even now, 2-2. Again, he sends it out of play. Another 2-2 offering, and this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2. And he lays off ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here. Lineup turns over, and to the plate, Howie Kendrick is looking for his third hit of the ball game here. Keeping it down here as it's to 1-2. Possible go-ahead runs on first, one away. Outside and low that time. Now it's two balls and two strikes. Here's the 2-2 pitch, and he fouls this one off. Got him. And that's the third time we've written a K next to his name in this one. Got him with a good high fastball there. Danny, we see a lot of that pitch in strikeout situations these days. What makes it so effective?
I think, Matt, what makes it such a tough pitch is you're changing eye levels. That fastball up looks so enticing to hit that you think you see that ball as a hitter. Do you think you can drive it? But it's really hard to get on top of that good, high, hard fastball.
Stepping in now, Yan Gomes. An even 2-2 count to the Nationals catcher.
Well, that's what you want from your curveball on 1-2. You start it in the zone and let it break out of the zone where it can't be punished. Didn't get him to go after it, but the execution was nice.
Still even at 2-2. Two out with the possible go-ahead run at first. Outside and a full count, 3-2. Ready with the payoff pitch. Hit hard to the right. Foul. And he misses with it, ball four. So the potential go-ahead run moves into scoring position now.
Will Harris trots in from the bullpen here as he inherits a tough spot with two on and two away. Gerardo Parra will be his first assignment here as he'll face him with runners at first and second and two away. The 1-1 pitch. Good breaking ball there, laid off for the second strike.
Hey, I don't mind that take right there. That was a nasty breaking ball. Started outside the zone, popped back inside the zone. Good spin rate on it. Move on to the next pitch.
Now the 1-2 pitch. 1-2 is the cut fastball, but he holds back 2-2.
It looked like he tried to get him to chase on that pitch there, 1-2. A good idea, but I think now he has to challenge him a little bit. He doesn't want to get into a worse situation with the cleanup guy up next.
Rendon at second. Gomes on at first with two down. Full count, 3-2. The payoff pitch, and he strikes him out here for out number three. So after a scoreless top half, they'll have a chance to win it here in the bottom half. So they let him off the hook here by scoring no runs despite the two walks. It's getting late. One run can win it as we move to the bottom of the 11th, all tied at 1-1. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Yuli Gurriel, struggling so far in this one and looking to erase his 0-for-4 ball game right here. And the winning run will reach. It's a leadoff walk to start the home half here in extra inning.
Man, when the game is tied, the last thing you can afford to do is walk the leadoff hitter. Got to focus on getting that ground ball now.
Stepping in is Josh Reddick. The winning run is at first base. The 1-1 pitch. And he pops up the bunt attempt. Zimmerman is there and he makes the catch for the out. So a runner at first now with one away. And striding in the speedy second baseman, Jose Altuve. Possible winning run on first, one man away. Into the corner and slicing foul. And look out, he has to back away there and then give a little glare out to the mound. It's ball two.
A lot of times you see guys in the middle of the order get worked away, but not right here. They're keeping it inside on him.
Is that an effort to keep him from getting extended, do you think?
Yeah, I think that's the idea, Matt. But he might spin to win if he starts looking for it in there.
And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight.
Anytime a pitcher locates a fastball on the inside corner, it's going to be a tough pitch to hit. That one was spot on, and he had no answer for it.
Standing in now, Jake Mariznick. Turned on that one and crushed it, just pulled it a little foul. Possible winning run stands at first with two out here. Ready with another two-strike offering. Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two. Before the pitch, a check on that winning run at first. And he has to dive, but he's back in easily.
Here's the 2-2 pitch. And he strikes him out to retire the side, so he'll play at least one more. Astros leave one. Score remains deadlocked at one. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Ryan Zimmerman. He's batting cleanup in this one, but will get us started here in the inning as they look to wake up the bats.
Yeah, not much to get excited about with just a single notch on the scoreboard, but you have to give credit to where it's deserved. The pitching on the other side has been really impressive.
Hit hard on the ground to the right, and that'll get through into right, so there's your possible go-ahead run on base to lead off the inning.
I don't know what side of the fence I fall on, boys. Old school, new school. I think I kind of stand right along that fence, but one thing that gets me jacked up is watching guys grind down an account and drive base hits the other way.
Into the box, Michael Taylor. Fouled off. Misses, ball two. Now the Astros have somebody up in the bullpen as a right-hander has started to warm up out there. Go-ahead runs aboard here at first with nobody out. This is lifted into the air out towards center field. Under it is Mariznick, one away. Programming note to pass along here. Due to the length of our ball game tonight, the Jody Kelce show will not be seen this evening so that we can bring you the conclusion of this ball game. Doggone. So a runner at first now with one away, and that'll bring up the power hitting second baseman Brian Dozier. The 1-1 pitch. This is foul right side. Now the 1-2 pitch. Oh, this is hit high and deep out to left. Not quite out of here. It's off the out-of-town scoreboard. Now a long throw to third, and he is in there at third as the possible go-ahead score.
That's what good hitters do. You get a pitch you like, and you just explode on it. He blasted that one over the left fielder's head for an easy double.
Coming to the plate now, Adam Eaton. His day at the plate hasn't amounted to much, 0-for-4, but this is a great opportunity to make amends.
Well, when your team really needs you, like they need it right here, you have to be able to put your personal struggles out of your mind. Right now is all that matters.
And it looks as though the decision makers in the dugout will give him a free pass to first, so the bases are loaded here on the intentional walk, and the force play is now in order.
Well, tough to say if that was their intention or not, but it's not the worst thing that could happen. A force at every base now, so there are a lot of ways to get out of this.
So bases are loaded. Nowhere to put him with one away. And that'll bring up one of the fastest players in all the land, Trey Turner. The 1-1 pitch. Strike two as the fastball is let go. Oh. And this is going to find the crowd down the left field line. Count holds at 1-2.
That wasn't a terrible pitch right there, but if he's going to execute and get this swing and a miss, he's going to have to get that ball a little bit further down, maybe even potentially bounce the next one.
Swing and a fly ball. This ought to at least get the go-ahead run in. Little is there. Let's see if they test it. Big spot here and stepping in Anthony Rendon as he'll hit with the go-ahead run at third and two away.
Yeah, right here.
2-2.
Definitely a big pitch coming up right here. He's going to be pumped if he can work his way out of this inning with the game still tied.
He's set. The 2-2. Fouled away. Zimmerman, the runner at third. Dozier over at second. Eaton at first. Two out in the inning. And he strikes him out here for out number three. So after a scoreless top half, they'll have a chance to win it here in the bottom half. Three left for Washington. Still tied, one apiece. Javi Guerra will be summoned here to start the home 12th, and the best case scenario for him is to take us to the 13th. So coming to the plate, Alex Bregman. He's 0 for 2 with a couple of walks in this one. Ready with the 1-1. Hit sharply on the ground. And this is going to get through into center, so there's your possible winning run aboard on the leadoff single.
Hey, that's a nice piece of hitting right there to put the winning run on base. Interesting here, this is where you play a little bit of manager. It's an AL game. Let's see if he employs a little National League style. Maybe ask the guy to bunt and move the runner up right here. I don't think so, though. American League, it's nasty. You're trying to drive something in a gap or over a wall.
In now, Carlos Correa. And this is lifted high in the air down the right field line. Eaton is over near the stands as he makes the catch for the first down. Striding in for Houston, Robinson Chirinos. 0 for 3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. The 1-1 pitch. Pitch out. Nothing doing. Action now in the Washington bullpen as a right-hander begins to get loose. Now the 2-1. That one catches the edge of the zone, called a strike. Now a good pitch around the knees, but it doesn't quite catch the bottom of the zone.
Not a bad time right here to put that runner in motion. 3-2 count. You send the runner, and if it's a bad pitch, it's ball four.
Oh, on the ground is short. Could this be two? There's one. Back to first. It's a double play, and we've got more baseball coming our way as the inning is over. So no runs on one base hit, no errors, and no one left on. Time to put the coffee pot on. 13th inning coming up. All tied at 1-1. Now at the plate, Howie Kendrick. He went down on strikes last time up. The 1-2. Misses above the zone for a ball. And it's fouled away.
Let's go, Astros.
The 2-2 one more time. Gets the outside corner, strike three. Standing in, Yan Gomes. One out, nobody on. And he fouls this one off. Another payoff pitch. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Payoff pitch one more time. And he lays off. Ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here. Ready now, Gerardo Parra. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up. Two and one to Gerardo Parra.
Man, he just missed the zone right there. One of the toughest pitches in the game, that backdoor cutter. As an offensive player, you give up on that pitch. As soon as it comes out of the hand, next thing you know, it's trying to grab the corner.
Now the 2-1. To short, hit hard. And that's through for a hit.
You don't get too many pitches a day in the big leagues, middle cut. His eyes lit up right there. This pitcher's lucky he's not getting another ball from the umpire.
Into the box now, Ryan Zimmerman. Breaking pitch, and this bounces in front of the catcher. Now the 2-1. And that's ball three now as it just misses below the zone.
I love the approach out on the mound. Everything's down in the zone as it should be, but now you find yourself in a 3-1 count. Do you elevate a little bit more and get back in this zone, or do you just pitch around them?
And that misses for ball four. So the potential go-ahead run moves over to third now.
Just a nice piece of hitting right there, especially in extra innings. He didn't try to win the thing by himself or be a hero. He just patiently worked the at-bat until he earned the walk. We'll see if his teammates can pick him up now.
Digging in now, Michael Taylor. It was a flyout for him in his last trip.
Yeah, give me the same at-bat. As you stride to the plate right here, give me the same execution. Just get something in the air. You got a chance to take the lead right here. Don't try and do any more.
On the move is Reddick. And the play is made, but this should be good enough for an RBI as the runner from third tags up. He's in there at the plate. And they've jumped ahead here in game six.
Hey, putting together good at-bats late in the games can really help out. And how about this sack fly right here? Good at-bat that leads to his team getting the lead here in the late innings.
Digging in, Brian Dozier. And looking to improve on a 1-for-5 effort so far. The 1-1. Gets him to swing at a pitch down and out of the zone, 1-2. And 2-2.
Boy, his pitch count has really spiked here in this inning. He's up to over 50 already.
Parra on second. Zimmerman on at first with two down. In the air and drifting out to shallow center. Mariznick is over. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. Only one in the inning for the Nationals. And now this crowd finds their club behind the eight ball here as they don't want to wind up on the losing end of this thing. Washington leads this one 2-1. Sean Doolittle enters from the pen now as they've saved their closer until this deep into extra innings. Now to the plate, Martin Maldonado. And at this point of the game, I think it's clear that the plan of attack against the top of the order has worked.
Well, when you've only surrendered one hit to the top three guys in the order up to this point in the game, you know you're doing something right, Matt. You're spot on. Whatever they discuss coming into this game has worked out beautifully.
The 1-1 pitch fouled off. Two count to the Astros catcher.
Tough to take a pitch like that right there, especially in a 1-2 count. You almost get in that auto swing mode. Great job to work the count back to even.
Sent in the air out to straightaway central. Taylor is right there, one down. Ready for another chance? Michael Brantley attempting to, as they say, get off the schneid here. 0 for 5 so far. Fouled away. Bases are empty, one man out. And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. Count remains 2-2. With another two strike offering. Now a check swing, and he went around, says the home plate umpire. No appeal needed, and there are two away. Now in the box, Yuli Gurriel, struggling so far in this one and looking to erase his 0-for-4 ball game right here. The 1-1 pitch and a bouncing ball, foul. Two out, nobody on. Last strike now for Houston. With another two strike offering that misses, and we're even at 2-2.
Well, that's a great take there right there, that slider down and in. That's one of the toughest pitches to lay off of as a hitter, that hard breaking ball coming down and in at the back foot. A tough take on a good pitch.
And kick off the celebration in our nation's capital. The Washington Nationals are the World Series champions.
Wow! World Series champions. The only thing that could have made this sweeter would have been doing it in front of the home crowd. But hey, they're not complaining, believe me. Now they can look forward to celebrating during the parade as they bring the World Series trophy home. What a moment for this team, this organization, and that city.
Back now on the show. It's all over, and you see the reactions there to the final out. And down on the field, we'll get a chance to watch the presentation of the Commissioner's Trophy to the new world champs.